On behalf of South African Black Women in Law, I am from Ziyabukwa in my capacity as the president of the organization. I am honored to be standing here to give an honor of the late Justice George Webster. Allow me to say, this is at a time when we just entered into the Women's Month, and also it is a time where we not only celebrate but also reflect on our accomplishments and also the challenges that we are facing in fighting against women empowerment and gender equality. While it is necessary to recognize, the country's democratic development, it is also becoming increasingly critical to also guarantee that women and children should see themselves in the faces of their leaders. In the words of Hillary Clinton, I quote, "We share a common future and we are here to find a common ground so that we may help bring new dignity and respect to women and girls all over the world." Justice George Webster embodied what it is to be resilient and also taking up space. This was evident in the matters that he adjudicated while protecting and restoring the rights of women and children. To name a few matters, the Ziyabukwa matter, which was held in this honorable court. The late Justice George Webster, before sentencing this man to life imprisonment for murdering his girlfriend and unborn child, he said, "Pregnant women are revered and protected in our society. The protection extends to women, be it they are pregnant or not, be it they are young or old." He continued to say, which means you strike a woman, you strike a man. He said, "If they are choose, has never heard of it, you must try to remember it." And also in an earlier matter that was held in Potchefstroom Magistrate Court, which was later referred into this honorable court, the sentencing of Isaac Kune, who knew he was HIV positive when he raped the two young girls. Justice George Webster said that he cannot find no reason to consider even one second that there are compelling circumstances to send Isaac Kune to jail for life. He added, "I hope in future you will examine yourself and find in you some inner goodness and regret what you have done to these innocent children. Children should be loved and should be cherished. He pointed out that women have the right to privacy and to work where they please without being molested. South African Black Women in Law is an international organization, that celebrates South Africa, Black women and law. We are founded upon dignity, equality, and freedoms infused in the philosophy of Ubuntu and Zenzele. And Justice George Webster was the epitome of that. And he will be, and we will continue celebrating his life for all the impact that he had in the society, for making sure that women and children's rights are protected and justice is served. May his soul continue to rest."